called shift-reduced grammar to more pronounce it more clearly, I intentionally add shift, reduce, accept or reject. These are four actions can be. Nothing, any other thing. Accept should be at the end, always in bottom-up parsing, in the top-down parsing also. And reject it any at point you do not find any suitable action as per the parsing table. Parsing table will be different other than top-down parsing table. Is a and you have a reject, and whenever you have reject, you have to whatever symbol at the available at the top of the stack, follow up that. If it's a variable, then follow up that you should give the output that here you can see the problems, and you can pop them off, and until and unless you have some symbols, terminals, which are basically used as a kind of markers, sort of like semicolon in C language, or what is your semicolon or second bracket closing. These are the standard thing as a because it is taken as a term, so that it is a block, so that you can until and unless for semicolon block you pop off, and then you start again if it is possible, because sometimes in whenever you see the parsing in your real life in a C program or Java program, it is not a single error. They give the multiple errors. Maybe one error can spawn many other errors, but some of the different errors also there. So that whenever you are giving the parsing action, so it is not only parsing. Always a good parser try to predict many errors in your program, not only one reject it comes up. So that is the error handling of a parsing. Error handling on a top-down parsing I have not yet covered. I give it some hint. Error handling in a bottom-up parsing, there is some panic mode, and there are various ways. These are the typical things comes in. So how to handle errors. This is the errors comes whenever reject, and it is, remember, it is not as if you see a first mismatch, you just go out. It is not. Parsing is more sophisticated. It will try to match any marker symbol like semicolon or second bracket closing, so that you can find at least something. Then try to parse like this. So here, the bottom of parsing, but I must say there is one anomaly there. You are seeing the I have taken not from the Aho's book, I have taken from others. It is they follow the same. Actually, in next examples onwards on bottom of parsing, we use from this end, not this end. So, in bottom of parsing, convention is generally as for Aho's book, a stack should contain that. Top-down parsing there. So this is a little bit of mismatch. It will come right now. That I am telling. This is from Aho's book. The stack is dollar, and at the end the A should come here. And in a top-down parsing, it will be this, and it will be blank. And if it's a bottom-up parsing, at the end it will come. Input should blank. Remember, $2 are different. It's the end of input marker, and this is the initial point of the bottom-up parsing. So stack goes here. Shift-reduced parsing is a form of bottom-up parsing in which stack holds the grammar server input paper, holds the rest of the string to pass. Yes. Handle is always appears at the top of the stack. Whether it is a handle, because everything happens at the not only at the top of the stack, in the few top of the stack symbols in bottom up parsing, in that especially, you just see the top of the stack, you cannot detect whether you want to reduce it or whether it is shifting. So, you have to have some information, you have to calculate from the, you have to guess it, how to guess so that there is a call a state information will cover that. So that is the thing. So that is the, you have to guess it correctly, that is a handle is there. Handle you probably. So stay right and then convert, discuss it, bottom person. We show the top of the stack on the right, yeah, rather than on the left. So it is the top down person. So this is the convention we have mentioned. We discussed that we show the top of the stack on the right rather than left is a top down person. Initially stack is empty. During left to right scan of the input string, the parser shifts 0 or more input, that is shift action onto the stack until it is ready to reduce a string beta of the grammar. Okay, it is on the production symbol right hand side beta on the top of the. If it reduces B to the head of the appropriate production, yes, the parser repeats the cycle until it has detected an error or until the stack contains the start symbol. Well, that is a summary of the things. Next comes, yeah. After entering this configuration, parser halts and announces successful configuration parsing. It is our books here you can see the, see here the stack is there as a bottom-up parsing. So first step I have told you, it is input. Bottom-up parser grows this way, unlike top-down, it is ID 1 and reduced by the this is the, as per the production rules, I should have, the production rules should be there. Yes, it is there. At the 8, this is the accept, see, E is the, your, here E is the production rules, is the start symbol of the grammar, it is accept. So, actions are shift, reduce, but fortunately, there is no conflict is whether to shift or reduce. We'll see that, the shift reduce complete, because without shifting also I can reduce it. So whether I shift or that is shift reduce, another major conflict is reduce conflict. So you can reduce it, but there are more than one rules is available. So there your parser should take the proper reduce function. There we need the state information of the stack on the top of the stack. So that's it. Yeah. So these are the four actions. So the primary operations are shift and reduce. There are actually four possible actions: shift, reduce, accept, and error or reject. This is very important point. The use of stack, the shift use is justified by important fact. Handle, that is the what is the, you have to reduce it. The, remember, there cannot be two handles. There will be one and only handle, and that handle must be, you have to detect it, and it should be at the top of the stack in the bottom of parsing, and you have to reduce by the proper rule. Handle means that any rule you can find that particularly the top of the stack symbols, including variables and terminals, you do not consider here state, because it will always push to the and it is on the right hand side of a production rule, and then we replace that with the left hand side variable. So we call it as a handle. It never inside, that is important. The handle will be always at the top of the stack. It is a rightmost derivation in reverse. Remember that. So there is one interesting grammar. It is all new in our programming language we have. That is if expression. This is an if expression then statement. If expression, then statement, else statement. So, if a statement comes, if expression, then statement, else statement, then we can reduce it by here also, or we can wait after the statement comes into the stack. We can wait for whether the else is coming on or not. So, we take the else, then we need the not LR0 grammar, we need LR1 grammar. I should look ahead. So, there will be action. Actually, all programming languages, they take this one first. Most then and else, which are matching closest. So, whenever if the bottom of parser sees the if expression then statement, then it can reduce itself. There's a conflict between shift reduce conflict. This is either I will shift whether I reduce. This is not reduce reduce conflict. Whether I can make this statement. I can wait for next else and another statement, we can do this. So it is shift reduce conflict, and there we should wait. Like here, see here is the your in the stack marker and it grows if expression then you are here, it is a handle. It's a handle. But if it's a handle, I should reduce it to this, or should I take this else? It is cannot be done by LR0. It will be can only possible by SLR or LLR or LR1 gamma. That means whenever I put LR0, I am totally blind what is coming there. So I am that is a blind. So like Gandhar, you can say. So whenever I take one look ahead and then I can see else it here, so I'll definitely make it a shift and then we not reduce it. So we cannot tell whether if expression then statement is the handle, no matter what happens below it on the stack. So there is a shift reduce conflict, and depending on what follows the else on the input, it might be correct to reduce it, expression statement, it might be correct to shift else and then to look for another statement to complete the expression then statement. So generally we prefer this one, shift. Most of the languages takes that way. But this is a unique good example of shift reduce conflict. And that can be holden, cannot be done by LL1 or LR0 grammar. Because LL1 it cannot be. You can appreciate because it's a two rules, it cannot be maybe LL1 cannot be. So this is it. Another common setting in conflicts occurs when you know have a handle, but the stack contents of the next input symbol are insufficient to determine which production should be used in reduction. So this is reduce conflict. The next example illustrates this. Here, these are the rules. We're coming to this. Suppose we have a lexical analyzer that returns a token name ID for all names, regardless of that type. It can be from a ID, maybe from procedure or maybe the array index. Suppose that our language invokes procedures for giving their names with parameters surrounded by parentheses, and that arrays are referred with the same syntax. Since the translation of indices in array reference and parameters into procedure calls are different, we want to use different productions to generate list of actual parameters and indices. So here we can see, we'll see that the two separate like we are starting to Shrutishpita, there's a noise is coming. Can you check it? Anybody's unmuted?
No sir.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, thank you. So here we have want to parse this tree. This and there's a two rules, like here rule number 5, right? Next rules will be clear. The rule number 5 parameter to ID and expression to ID. Both the rules are coming. So if it is a bottom-up parsing, shift-reduce parsing, so we have the total string is input buffer is ID at this comma ID. So we shift it here, then shift. Now I am in a conflict whether reduce it, but with the two rules to reduce, rule number 5 or rule number 7, which rule to use? So there is a rule come from our old syntax analyzer Lexeme. So if the Lexemes are more sophisticated, they give an idea. This ID is a different ID. I will name it a differently. It will change differently. Like it is evident that the ID on the top of the stack must be reduced, definitely. But which by which production? The correct choice is the production 5. See, if P is a procedure. Can be procedure, but production 7 P is an array. The stack doesn't tell which information in the symbol table obtained by the declaration P must be used. So there we must take in the compiler. So here we see we can add a proc ID. It is evident that ID on the top of the stack must be reduced, but which production I've told. One solution is to change the token ID in the production 1 to proc ID. That is we change the name of the terminal, that is procedure. Token ID, and to use a more sophisticated lexical analyzer that returns a token named proc ID when it recognizes its lexeme and token almost the same name, meaning there's a name of the procedure. But lexeme is preferred, it's a procedure. Doing so would require the lexicographer to consult the symbol table before returning it to me. Okay. If we made this modification, then on processing, this is a procedure, the parser would be either in that configuration, proc ID, here an ID. So now we want to reduce the ID by rule number 5, but here the rule number 5 is dictated by the bottom of the stack. Position number, if you can say position number 1, 2, 3, third item, it dictates which production rules to use. So you can see not only this is the top of the stack in bottom up parsing, that doesn't dictate whether rule number 5 or 7, something before that, which is the terminal, it will prompt you. So how to get this information, because you cannot see the stack 2-3 elements prior. So that is one of the reasons we give a different ID, the proc ID, then the handle. This is the handle. Then in the former case, we choose reduction by production 5. In the later case, whenever this ID comes, then we'll produce by not by 5, rule number 7. Notice how the symbol third from the top, like here, of the stack determines the reduction to be made, even though it is not involved in the reduction. But it will tell you to use the production rule number 5, but here with this ID will reduce it by the rule number 7. You can utilize the information far down in the stack to guide the parts. So let's clear it. Introduction to LR, simple LR. So this is simple LR is just better than shift reduce. The most prevalent type of bottom-up parsing today is this concept called LRK parsing, L from left to right scanning, R is constantly rightmost division in reverse, and K is the number of inputs. If always say the K is always 1 or 0, and if it is nothing mentioned, it is K is 1. We shall consider LR parser K equal to, when K is omitted. The section read introduce the basic concept of LR parsing and easiest method of constructing shift reduce parser called simple LRs. It is just better SLR or short. Some favorite the basic concept helpful even in the LR parser itself because using the automatic parser generator. Here it is an automatic parser generator routine is there. We begin with items it is called the, this I have told you the parser states. In the stack, you push into the LR0, we'll start from shift reduce to LR0, SLR, LLR, or LR1. Your just parsing table is different. Your program will be the same, only the parsing table is different. Size will be highest in the LR1 and canonical LR1, and LR0 is minimum table entries, but the problem will be it cannot handle the all types of grammar. So that is called parser states, and will come some items. This is the best one, canonical LR, and LR is less number of entries there that are using majority LR parser. So our ideal target is to understand fully the LLR, canonical LR, but we have to understand from basic shift reduce parser. Why LR parser? LR parser are table driven, same as a top down parser, much like non recursive, same top down parsing. But the parsing only that similarity ends there and stack there. But in position, I have told you the stack will be different and the parsing table will be different. But one good point of the LR parsing is the program will be the same. But your table would be different for LR0, SLR, LLR, canonical LR. The program may be the same. At least the book says that. That's so. So, LR parsers a grammar which can cause a parser table using one of the middle section and LR. Intuitively, a grammar set to be LR is sufficient, that is, left to right shift reduce parser to be able to recognize handles of right sentential form when they appear on the top of the stack. Yes, that is top of the stack, handle you have to detect. LR parsing is attractive for a variety of reasons. LR parser can be constructed to recognize virtually all programming languages. That is great, for which context-free grammars can be written. Okay, and non-LR context-free grammar exists. That is great thing. Non-LR context-free grammar exists, but this can generally be avoided for typical programming language. I have told you that there is always a gap between the even the LR one, LRK, because LR one is a set, LR two bigger set, LRK much bigger set, but it never touches the all the unambiguous deterministic context-free grammar. There will be always some grammar that is unambiguous deterministic, but you cannot have parsing by even the LRK, K maybe 1, 2, 3. So these grammars can be, again, this grammar can be parsed. It is called CYK algorithm. That is one of the best algorithms. So that is, I try to cover, it is not the syllabus, the CYK algorithm that can parse, and there it is not top down or bottom up. They try at any position, it's a dynamic programming type, and they make it less than n cube. Generally, it is less than, but definitely not O(n). Complexity is not O(n), it is less than O(n) cube. I have told you the theoretical limit of the parsing is O(n) cube. So there will be definitely some efficient parser out there, but they are not O(n). But languages have some. This kind of grammar can be there, you should be aware of, which cannot be parsed by top down and bottom up. So, but summary, I can say the top down is the simplest, bottom up, it takes care of almost all unambiguous deterministic grammar, but there's some grammar which cannot be done by even the most sophisticated LRK grammar. So the LR parsing method is most general non-backtracking. Non-backtracking must be shift-reduce parsing method known, yet it can be implemented as efficiently as other more primitive shift-reduce method. That we yet to start. An LR parser can detect syntactic error as soon as it's possible to do so on a left-to-right scan of it. Then LR grammar syntactic error detection is much faster than LL grammar. Class of grammars that can be parsed using LR methods is a proper subset. Yes. Proper superset, that is very important. The class of grammar that can be parsed with predictive or LL methods. For a grammar to be LRK, we must be able to recognize the occurrence of the right side of the production in the right sentential form with K input simple look ahead. We generally call it a 1. This requirement is far less stringent than LLK grammar, where we require K more than 1, where we must be able to recognize the user production seeing only the first K symbols. What is right side of the universe? It should not be surprising. LR grammar can describe more language. So LR grammar is always superior, but it can handle left recursion. You do not have to remove left recursion and all these things. So LR grammar definitely superior. That I try to convince. The principal drawback of LR method is that it is too much work to construct a LR parser by hand for a typical programming language grammar. A specialized tool, LR parser generator, is needed, and it is top-down parsing, you can create your parsing table by hand, but if you have a number of grammar instructions or more, you need a tool. Fortunately, many such generators are available. We shall discuss one of the most commonly. We try to cover, and if one of you has a presentation that is nice, such a generator takes context-free grammar and automatically produces parser for that grammar. If the grammar contains ambiguities and other constants that are difficult to parse or left to right scan, then the parser generator locates these constants and probably, so it will give a diagnostic message also. So there I almost come to the end that these are some items I have told you in a bottom up parsing. There is a concept called items and closer. So if it is a production rules, how does shift reduce parser knows when to shift and when to reduce? For example, when stack contains $T, see rows here, next input symbol is star in particular figure in Aho's book, how does the parser know that T is at the top of the stack is not a handle? So that appropriate action to shift, not to reduce, to T2. The LR parser makes shift into decision by maintaining states. That I always telling you that your stack should contain not only the variables or terminals, but also states. keep the track of where we are in the past. State represent the set of items. LR0 item, item for slot. LR0 item means I will not, my action will not depend on the next input symbol like what I look ahead. That is LR0. For the dot at some position of the body. Then the production is the 4 items. A to like this, A to epsilon g dot. Intuitively item indicates how much production of a we have seen at the given point. For example, so whenever we are this rule that we see right now, we can make a reduce, but where you are in this state, you cannot reduce. You cannot reduce, but whenever you are taught, you can reduce because we have all the end of a particular, it can be a probable handle. Representing item set, a parser generator that produces a bottom-up parser may need to represent items and sets of items confidently. Note that item can be represented by pair of integers, first of which a number of the production rules. I prefer it is a production, you can use the production of P1, number of production rules of the underlying grammar, and second is which position of the dot. Okay. The set of items can be represented by a list of these pairs. However, we shall see the necessary sets of items often include closer. Closer means take the all possible options. When the dot is at the beginning of the body, there can always be reconstructed from the other items in the set, and we do not have to include them in the list. We'll explain in the next classes. Here it indicates that we have just seen the input of the string derivable from x, and we hope to see next string derivable from y check. Indicates that we have seen the body. So this signifies we have seen the body. It will be item to reduce. So if we have, so this we have to catch it. One collection of sets LR0 items called the canonical LR0 collection. This is important. Provides the basis of constructing deterministic finite automaton that is used to make parsing decision. Such an automaton called LR0 automation. We first try to understand LR0. In particular, each state LR0 automation represent a set of items in the canonical LR collection. We make a combine together. The automation of expression grammar opens with the running example, the expression in our grammar. Okay,